listeners. So now, we're back for another episode of Chika Tea. And for today, ang flavor ng ating tea ay Role of Media in Democracy. At pag-uusapan rin natin kung mapagkakatiwalaan pa ba sila or hindi.
So we'll be tackling the roles of media and democracy and how can we say that the media is telling the truth.
But before we start, let's welcome our guest, Mr. Rael Aklan, a grade 12 STEM student from University of the East. We'll be answering some of our questions and share his insights. Let's give him a round of applause.
Hello!
Hi, Rael. Thank you for being our guest, and we're very excited to have this conversation with you.
Well, it's a pleasure to be invited here, so shall we start na?
Okay, yes.
Lahat naman tayo aware that there are different media outlets in the Philippines, diba? So, first question, what are the roles of the media in democracy ba?
For me, they are the ones who disseminate information to the people and urge us to exercise our rights and make our own decisions. But how can we trust media?
For me, I don't trust the media fully. May mga times na hindi sila objective and nag-a-add sila ng info sa isang specific news kahit hindi naman dapat. And lastly, napoproject yung opinions or yung personal judgment nila when broadcasting. Siguro, para magkaroon tayo ng trust sa kanila, dapat maging transparent sila and mag-stick lang on stating the facts and wag na gumawa ng kwento para sila yung panoorin ng mga tao. Sabi nga nila, the media outlets should communicate the truth to the people.
Yes, I agree sa mga nasabi mo. Pero nagagawa ba ng media yung trabaho nila?
It's a yes for me. Kasi nga, di ba, nung recent elections, they have served as citizens by updating what is happening. Tsaka sa debate rin, yung debate na dahil sa media, malalaman natin opinions ng mga running officials in which we can broaden our perspective and choose wisely pa.
Although may mga media agency na suspicious at sobrang biased, di ko naman sinasabi na SMN na ito. Pero parang ganun na nga, I think they deserve na masabi na di lahat ng media nagagawa ng maayos yung responsibility nila in democracy.
Hoy, wait lang! May award naman yung SMNI, Best Trusted News Broadcasting Company noong 2021 and 2022 ng Golden Globe Awards. Pero hindi ba parang may mali? Mayroon na tayong kilalang 3 major media outlets, which are the ABS, GMA, and TV5. Hindi pa ba sila sapat? Aren't they credible enough? Bakit biglang may lumalabas na SMNI TV outlet? Who is the one telling the truth?
Yes, can we ask Mr. Rael, what is his thoughts about mainstream media?
So, for me naman ha, as a student citizen, reliable and credible pa rin naman ang mainstream media because every news or information na pinapalabas nila, they should undergo a series or a major process of deliberation and editing sa newsroom bago maipalabas ang isang headline or isang news. So for me, reliable, trusted mainstream media kasi nga naka-undergo sa series of editing and deliberation bago mapalabas ang isang particular news.
Yes, that is a very good point. But what can they do to be more credible? Kasi nga, di ba may mga explicit threats to press freedom?
Yes, for me, I think na maganda na mas madaming statistics and evidences from experts whenever something is happening. Kasi having expert na nagsasabi ng opinions nila or explanation nila can make media more credible. And it would be nice to be hearing both sides para hindi maging bias ang mga tao. Maganda rin na magbigay sila ng mga proof na transparent sila para mapaniwalaan sila ng mga tao. Ngayon na nanganib yung credibility nila, they need to step up their game talaga.
Yes, I agree. And before we end this episode, we would like to ask Mr. Rael on the last question. What should be the responsibility of the citizens towards the information that the media conveyed in protecting democracy?
Well, for me, everything talaga has two sides. May positive at negative sides talaga yan. So as the mainstream media, pwedeng maging biased at pwede ding maging truthful lahat ng news or information that they convey. So the role of the citizens or the responsibility of the Filipino citizens is that they should learn to fact-check every information or news that they would be taking on. Dapat pina-fact-check nila yung source. Kapani-paniwala ba ang source? Yung content, are the content truthful? Totoo ba yung sinasabi? Hindi ba fake news? Yun dapat. Filipino citizens should be vigilant para ma-preserve, ma-protect, at ma-keep natin ang democracy sa pakikipaglaban against the media, sa pinapaniwalaan natin.
Okay, so that ends it. Thank you, Mr. Yael. Ang dami naming nakuha sa'yo ng mga insights and opinions. Naniwala na agad kami for today. Okay, and that's all for today's episode of Chika Tea. Hope that everyone enjoyed our podcast. Until next week.
Thank you.